Hi, and welcome to Straight Up Tech, your very own Unity learning community with the motto, let's learn together. In our last video, we learned how we can design animations without the animator controller and make them work. In this video, we are going to learn how we can create an animator controller to control our animations. For this, we'll open our old project that we did in the last video, the 3D animation tutorial, and in this you will create a new scene. I'm going to save my scene first and I'm going to name it 3D animator test. Save it. Now for this I have chosen Elf Dual Blade, which is available on the asset store of the Unity. You can download it from there and then you can drag and drop it to your asset folder. Now in this Elf Dual Blade, we have the controller, the demo, the mesh, the motion, the prefab, the texture. But we are going to create our own demo. So what we are going to do is, we are going to go to our game object, 3D game object, and plane on which our character will be standing. Then from the prefab, I'll select one of the elf dual blade character and place it. Then it is always good to reset the character. See, now it is, the character is all set up and ready. Now we will create its animator controller. To do that, first I'm going to create a animator controller. So create animator controller. I will name the animator controller as elf controls. Then I'm going to create a new folder. Name it as animations. Then drag my animator controller in this, double click it. Okay, so we have our animator controller. Now here what we want to do is, we will use its walk, drag and drop the script, we'll drag and drop the motion here. Then we will use stand as the idle. Then I'm going to take obviously the death animation, the damage animation, the attack animation, and the airborne animation. Now I'm going to create the states through which we will use these animation. So first the entry state, I'll bring my any state here. I'll make this stand as its default state. So always remember, the one with the orange color is the default state. This means that whenever this controller will be called, or the game object will have this state whenever the game will start. Then we need it to walk. Now death can be from any state. We need it to take damage. We need it to attack. We want that all this should be from its default state. So first I'm going to create a bool and name it as walk. Another bool, name it as damage. Another trigger, name it as damage. Then I'm going to create another bool, name it as attack, and another trigger, name it as jump, and then finally a trigger and name it as death. Now as you know, bool is used to check whether the condition is true or false. So if the condition is true, then it will play that animation. If it is false, then it will go back to its original animation. And trigger is just like bool, but you do not have to set false because it goes to the false state automatically. So first we'll set up this transition. From any state the elf can experience death. I will make the transition from death, save it. Then from stand it can walk, and when it is not walking it can go and stand again. So in this I'm going to use walk true, and in this I'm going to use walk as false. Then to damage I'm just going to trigger it. If it is walking then also it can experience the damage, and even if it's standing then also it can experience the damage. From walk it can experience airborne, and from airborne it can go back to its walking. So we will make the transition as jump. We don't need that transition. And it can jump from standing also. So, and I will make this transition to attack and we transition back to. Now what I'm going to do is I'm going to create UI and buttons. So first of all I'm going to create a canvas, name it as control. Then I'm going to create a panel. Name it as control panel. Then I'm going to set my 2D and go in. Now I'm going to create my button and make it a child of the control panel. Now I will name the button according to the animations I want it to play. So I have the following animation. The first I'll we are going to name the button as our animation. And the first I'm going to do is I'm going to name it as walk. And I will change the button text to walk. Then I will duplicate it. Then I'm going to change the position. This. And duplicate it. I'll drag the button to the side. I name this as damage and duplicate the button again. I name this as on the panel. We'll do add component and name the script as button control new script create an add, and then to our game object we'll add component and animator controller. So it has the animator controller installed. Now we will change its controller from the controller which we have made. Save it. We'll open the script. Now in this first we need to have a reference to the controller. So we will create animator nm. Now we have to establish that reference. To do that we will go void awake function. In that we are going to give the nm to get component animator we established the reference. Now we are going to create the functions, so that we will create the functions to use the animator. So first of all, we will create public void walking, and that we are going to do. Now since walking was a bool function, we are going to write nm.setBool in the braces. We need to write the name same as we are given in the animator controller. So we have the walk parameter here, so we will write walk comma true. This means that set the boolean value to true so the player can walk. Then we have public void attack function. So to use this, we'll go back to the animator controller and see. Now attack is also a bool function, so you'll write nm dot set bool the name should be the same, attack, set this to true. Then we have our trigger functions, which are public void player dead. So we'll write nm dot set trigger and the string name of the parameter, which is death. I think it is death. Yep, it is death. Then we have one more button, that is the damage button. Damage is also a trigger function, so we will write public void take damage function and nm set trigger damage. See, yep. Now we are going to assign our functions to our buttons. So to do that, we will select our first button, that is the walk button. In this, we will drag and drop the component in the on. We will drag and drop the component in the on click function. Then we are going to select the button control and walking function. This button will do the walk, and the damage, you can add the component. See, and drag and drop the game object on the script. Drag and drop the game object on which the script is written. Button control. Then damage, take damage. Save. Then on the attack button, we are going to do the same. Drag and drop the game object of the script. Button control. The attack function. And finally, the dead function. Same, drag and drop this, then player dead. I'm sorry, the spelling mistakes are there because I'm writing very fast. So I'll save this. Then, as always, I'm going to press. Now, before pressing play, you will see that some kind of haziness is there. This is because we have not set the panel to completely transparent. So we'll do that. Again, save, maximize on play, and then play. So this is how the player is walking. And when you click damage, this is how it will take damage. When you click attack, this is how it will attack, and finally when we click dead, this is how it will react. So this is the second way in which you can use the animation, by using the animator controller, and you can set the effects according to yourself and how the transition should be performed. So this was all for today's episode. Thank you for watching Straight Up Tech. Let's learn together. Don't forget to subscribe and click on the bell icon so you never miss a video from us again. Thank you.